Hey guys, Colin Smith here from PhotoshopCafe.com. This week I'm going to show you how to take a photograph and turn it into a pencil sketch in Photoshop. Alright, here's a fun effect I've actually been doing for years. I actually have a written tutorial about this at PhotoshopCafe.com. So if you want to follow along with the steps, just check out the steps underneath. There's a link there. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you in a video right now how to take a photograph and make it look like a pencil sketch. Then at the end, I'm going to do a couple of fun little creative touches to it. So without further ado, let's just jump right in and get started right now. All right, so what you want to do is you want to start with an image. Notice I'm viewing this image at 100% view, which is full size. You really want to do that when you're doing this effect. Now, this is an image I grabbed from Adobe Stock. You can see up here, beautiful young woman with red rose. Just do a search on there and you'll be able to find it. Or just use one of your own photos. This technique works for any photo. So the first thing we're going to do is I'm just going to duplicate this. So I'm going to grab it here and just click and drag to the new layer icon, and this creates a copy. Now the reason I'm doing this is just to preserve the color one in the background. We didn't actually really need to do that, but we're going to do our effect up here. So the first thing we want to do is get all the color out of here. So we just need to desaturate it. You could hit Command Shift U or Control Shift U to desaturate, or just go up under the menu here. And you can just go under Image, Adjustments, and then just go down to Desaturate. And if you click there, what we've done is we've just desaturated it. So what we have right now is we have a black and white layer here. So what I want to do now is I want to duplicate this. I want to copy it. So you can hit Control-J or just click and drag down here to make a copy. So now we have two copies of it. We want to take our first copy at the top and we want to invert this. So we want to have the exact opposite of what we're looking at. So we can just hit Control-I, that would be Command-I on Mac, and now we've created an inverted copy. So what we have now is the black and white in regular and inverted. So we're just going to use the blend mode, which is where all the magic happens. So we're going to go up to the blend mode here, and we're going to change this to Color Dodge. And we can see when we do that, pretty much all the detail is gone. Quite often you're going to see a completely white canvas. Don't worry, don't be alarmed, because we make the magic happen by going under here, under Filter Blur. Now we're going to go down to the Gaussian Blur, and voila, you see we start to get this sketch. So we can really decide how thin we want it. So if we go all the way down to very, very narrow radius, notice you can get a very pencil looking sketch with very, very thin lines. And, you know, and as we increase it, we start to see more detail. So you can get it, you know, almost just like a black and white version right there. So you want to find about where you like it. I'm kind of digging it about here. It's looking pretty good. I'm liking the lips and the eyes here in particular and the hair. So we just click OK. And then essentially what we've done is we've created from that a pencil sketch. Now what we want to do though is do some cool coloring effects. I'm going to show you a couple of different techniques right now. One, if I wanted to actually grab the color from the original, this is how I would do it. I just click and drag down here to duplicate it, drag it to the top, and now what I'm going to do is change the blend mode here because I don't want to show all the luminosity. All I want to show is the color. So I'm going to change this to color blend mode, and notice now we get that effect there where we're showing the color. Now we could desaturate that just by grabbing opacity, pull it down, just put a little bit of color in there. And I think that creates a really nice effect. Now here's another option. I'm going to turn this off. And I'm going to show you an option that I've seen in different movie posters and stuff like that. It's been quite a popular technique. I'm just going to create a new layer. Actually, rather than just create a layer though, I'm going to go over and I'm going to grab a layer style, actually an adjustment layer. And I want a gradient. So we're going to click and we're going to apply a gradient adjustment layer. Okay, so what we want to do is we're going to change this gradient to, I don't know, rainbow colored gradient. And we're just going to click here and I'm going to change the angle of that. So we've got a nice kind of an angle effect. And I'm just going to click OK. Right now you just see the rainbow. You don't see anything on there. It's not that exciting. Change it to color blend mode. And now it starts to look quite interesting. We get this really cool effect. Now I'm going to show you something which is really awesome. If you double click on here, you might not know this about layer styles. You know, you can scale them. You probably knew that. But if we're going to gradient, if we want to change the color, we can just simply click and drag. And notice as we're dragging, we're actually dragging the different colors of that gradient. So we can go backwards and forwards until we find the colors that we like. And I'm kind of just going through these different colors here. And I kind of like about there. I think that's a pretty neat effect. So, you know, you can see you can do that and then just click OK to apply it. Now, you could blend the two together if you wanted. You'd have to drop this color down a little bit and blend that a little bit with the original color. Now, I'm going to show you one last variation where we can make this look a little bit more like pencil or even charcoal kind of an effect. So I'm just hiding that top layer and I'm going to create a curves adjustment. So let's just grab a curves. And then with the curves adjustment, what we're going to do is we're actually going to roll off on the blacks a little bit. So we're going to grab that point, just pull it up a little bit. And what we're doing is reducing the contrast there in the blacks, making a softer image. And now what we want to do is go up in the highlights a little bit and just pull it down, bring out a little bit more detail here. See, that's some of that detail is coming out. Just be careful not to overdo it. And we'll just grab that curve there so we don't lose too much there. And you can see this is another variation. So if I go here and we look at it before and after, you can see I was able to take that and just sculpt some of that information out there. The other thing I could do is that is I could drag it down, I could turn on the color, and I could do a combination here. Let me bring that down a little bit, make sure I grab the color layer, reduce that color even more, and just give it just a little touch of color. And now we have, you know, another variation. So you can see there's a ton of different things you can do with this effect. There's a lot of different things you can do with it just by experimenting and applying different color effects on top of it. So as you can see, it was really easy to achieve this effect. And if you want the steps, just check out the written tutorial. I have the link underneath there. So just click on that and check it out. So anyway, if you enjoyed this, hit the subscribe button so I can give you a new episode, because we're making regular episodes all the time, and I'll get that out to you. And the other thing, hit the like button and add a comment. You know, tell me, hey, you know, are you having fun with this? Post a final result in here if you like. I'd love to see what you're doing with this effect. I'd also like to know what you'd like to learn. So once again, thanks for checking us out here at Photoshop Cafe. And don't forget to check out our main site, photoshopcafe.com, where we've got hundreds of tutorials. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.